Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, so I just saw you coming and petting my dogs, and I realized that you like animals.
Yep.
Yeah. So I asked you if you're vegetarian or non-vegetarian, and you said you're non-vegetarian.
Yeah, right.
Right? How often do you eat non-veg?
Thrice a week.
Okay.
Twice or thrice a week.
Okay. And do you eat chicken, fish, eggs, milk? What do you have?
Like? Chicken, fish, egg, all.
All. Okay. Tell me, would you kill an animal yourself? Would you kill a chicken yourself?
Probably not.
I'm very happy to hear that, because that means you're a compassionate person. Yeah, you wouldn't like to take a life, and that is so, I mean, that is wonderful to hear. Most people, when I ask them, they say, oh, they wouldn't kill a chicken themselves. Do you have mutton?
Yep.
Would you kill a goat yourself?
No.
Lovely. So that means you're a really compassionate person, right?
Yep.
And I love the fact that you so openly said, oh, without thinking, no, kill an animal. Now, why is it that though you're compassionate and you have such a beautiful core values, yeah, you still end up eating animals? You pay somebody to kill them, right?
Right.
That means you're killing an animal. Unless you kill them, you can't eat them. So how is it that you end up doing that? This, even though your personal core values are so beautiful.
Okay, so, yep, I know that is one dilemma.
Louder,
that
please.
That is one dilemma that, like, generally would cloud my mind. But the thing is that, I guess, like, I'm 23 years old right now, and since I've been brought up in a family which actually loves adults non-vegetarian food. And
exactly. So you were born in a family that ate non-vegetarian food, and it was given to you, and so you developed the taste for it.
Right.
Now tell me, as a child, did they explain to you that here, this is a chicken, it's a 40-day chicken, it's a baby, and we're going to kill it and give it to you to eat?
No.
Then nobody explained that to you, right? So, were you given a choice? You were never given the choice,
right?
If you were explained that, okay, this is a 40-day-old chicken, it is a baby, and we're going to kill it and give it to you, give the flesh to you to eat, what would you have probably said if you were a child?
Say, I don't want it or something.
Exactly. You would probably have said, no, don't kill it. I want to play with it, right? And these are only babies. They are just 40-day-old chickens. They are like a one-year-old or a two-year-old, you know, if compared to humans.
Right.
And we're killing babies. So this is because society conditions us into accepting this violence as something normal.
Right.
Yeah? Society tells us it's perfectly okay to kill a chicken and I won't say anything to you. In fact, they tell us it's necessary, it's natural, it's normal.
Yep.
Right. Would you eat dog meat?
No.
Excellent. Why wouldn't you eat dog meat?
Well, for one, like, I like dogs, but that's not it. Like, so, yeah, I get the argument because why are we distinguishing among animals like dogs, cats as our pet animals, and then when we're
society conditions us. Yeah, we are compassionate people. Most of us are compassionate people. Our conscience says it's wrong. Our core values are of compassion, kindness, peace, justice. But we just follow society. And it's been happening for years. It's not something new. So we never think of questioning it. Everyone is doing it. It's a dominant ideology. It's a dominant belief system that is accepted as normal all over the world. So we as individuals never think of questioning it. Had you thought about this before?
Well, like, to tell you the truth, I actually had thought about it. I had also considered veganism for
a while. Oh, lovely. So you know what veganism is.
Yep. Although the thing is that, so I started with it, but then between being a vegetarian and being vegan, I do like milk, having milk.
Yeah.
Now, since veganism is even against anything that is like...
That comes from an animal.
That stopped milk from being available. But the thing was that what I still think is that the commodification of animals.
Yeah.
That is the real issue here, because if you look at it, like, if you look at, like, 2 centuries ago, you wouldn't have found such a big, huge industry of people just slaughtering animals. And that is all that is wrong with the world. So it's not that I wouldn't believe that, like, killing animals might have been a human tradition for a long time, and maybe that was followed for two centuries ago also. But right now it has turned into an industry of like slaughter, and like animals are actually grown, genetically modified and grown into getting killed.
So you're very informed.
Yeah, I'm very informed.
That's wonderful. Yeah. How is it that you're so informed?
So the thing is that, so my dilemma is that, okay, even if I do stop eating chicken and like that animal kind of non-veg, I still also like having fish, which is very ingrained into me, and like I don't think I can bifurcate between the two. So I have actually went in and like thought about it a lot, and I've I've researched ki, like what is happening in the world. But when it comes to like taking the action, one thing that I can do is like I can stop all kinds of like animal food that
wonderful.
I eat, but but when it comes to fish, it's very
difficult,
traditional and like so.
Are you
in
Bengali?
General, no, I'm a Maharashtrian, but my mom cooks very nice fish, so that
so
is something
think,
that is very
So maybe we can discuss this.
Yep.
Oh my God, there's so much noise here. So, have you watched See the Truth? S-E-A, The Truth. Have you watched the documentary? S-E-A, The Truth. It's available on YouTube.
Okay, no, I haven't.
Yeah,
seen,
so I think you should watch it so that you understand the what is happening actually, what we are doing to our oceans and how we are destroying our oceans, and how by 2050 or 2048 they say the oceans will be empty and you know, life will come to a standstill if fish disappear. So there are a lot of things that we are unaware of. I think you should watch that. Yeah, and you should also watch End of the Line to see how big companies like Mitsubishi and all are involved in fisheries. It's because of big money that they are capable of destroying the oceans. So it's something we are unaware of. Become aware. Yes. So but you're so aware and still you're eating. Yeah. Now tell me one thing. I want you to get in touch with your heart here. Yeah. Tell me, if there was a chicken or a goat that was going to cross the road, that is crossing the road, and a car was going to run over it, what would you instinctively do?
Try to stop the car or something.
Exactly. You would try to save the animal.
Right.
Yes. And yet, you kill animals and eat them. So your feelings, yeah, your heart says one thing, and your actions, you're doing something totally different.
Right.
They're not in alignment. And we are taught not to listen to our hearts.
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, if you really listen to your heart, would you be able to eat animals?
I probably wouldn't.
Yeah, because you are compassionate. Inherently, you're a compassionate person. Yeah? You're such a wonderful person. Your core values are of peace and justice. Like you said, you wouldn't distinguish between the animals. Yeah? Milk is something also you think is difficult for you to give up. Right. Now tell me, when does any animal produce milk? Any animal? Cat, dog, human, horse, donkey, elephant, cow, buffalo, giraffe?
When they're having
kids. Baby, yes. Exactly. Why has nature put milk in the body of that animal?
To feed the animal.
It's meant for a newborn baby to grow very fast in a short period of time. And because the baby doesn't have teeth, it's liquid nutrition.
Right.
Now, when we take milk from a cow or a buffalo, what exactly are we doing?
Stealing it from the
Would you as an individual do such a thing? Would you steal the food of a baby?
No, I wouldn't.
See, so as individuals we are really compassionate and kind people, but society conditions us into accepting this violence as something very normal, and sometimes they tell us it is good for us that we need it. But do you really need violence and abuse?
No, I don't think so.
Do you need violence on your plate? Every time you sit down to a meal, you're celebrating violence and abuse of animals and suffering. Would you want that?
Probably would.
Exactly. Now imagine the chicken that is being killed. What do you think it's going through? What feelings does it have? Fear, anxiety, trauma, stress. That's what we're eating, because those chemicals are activated in the body of that animal. Would you want to be eating such things?
No.
Had you ever thought about that?
Actually, yes. So I have been in a fight with myself about it for some time. So
wonderful.
I'm always thinking about it.
Yeah. See, so that means otherwise you wouldn't have been in a fight.
Right.
Like, have you chopped vegetables? Have you cut up a fruit or a, you know, vegetable? Have you?
Yeah.
And do you feel bad about it? Are you in conflict with yourself about that?
No.
If there were a tomato or a cucumber on the road and you were going to, you know, a car was going to run over it, would you run to save it?
No,
probably not. Yeah, you'd feel bad that it was wasted.
Yep.
But you wouldn't run to save it. So there's no conflict here. But the fact that you're in conflict with yourself is amazing, because that is what will help you decide.
Right.
Yeah? And now that you've got the information, do you think the next time you want to eat, you will want to listen to your heart and get in touch with your heart, listen to who you are,
right,
or listen to what society tells you? What do you think?
I'd like to listen to myself.
Sorry, you would?
Listen to myself.
You would really do this, or you're just saying this to make me feel happy?
No, like, I have been actually thinking about this, so probably I'll...
Wow, wonderful. Awesome. And we can help you with that. Yeah,
okay,
I've been vegan for 6 years, more than 6 years now.
Okay.
And I remember how traumatic it was when I, you know, when I made that connection, because I watched a video called Earthlings and I was shocked that I was the reason for so much suffering. And we do not realize this. I had not given anybody permission to do anything to such horrible things to an animal, and they had told me I need it. I definitely don't need this, yeah?
Right.
And it's not very difficult to step out of the system if you are in touch with your core values, your beliefs, your, you know, compassionate nature.
Right.
It's not difficult, because then you feel so much peace, because you've chosen who to be, who you are.
Right.
Yeah? So I'll take down your number maybe.
Yep, yep, sure.
And help you. You can join us.
Yep, I would also like to like talk about what is the long term plan. So I should get back to you, I'll connect to you sometime.
Yeah, what long term plan are you talking about?
In terms
about?
Of the like spreading veganism or getting, so yeah, I get it. Like if I make a change,
yeah,
I may teach my family some
exactly.
values.
Exactly. And so, what do you think I'm doing?
You're spreading the
yeah,
message.
Yeah, I do this all the time.
Right.
We have a whole group of people who do this all the time. So word is getting out. How did you come to know about veganism? I was surprised to know that you knew so much. Because most people I come across are so unaware.
I had tried it out actually.
Wow.
For a while.
Oh, wow. Do you know anything about whole food plant-based nutrition?
Yeah, I've heard about it, but I've like, so
you
when I say I tried it, I just stopped stuff from
okay.
my diet.
Yeah, but you didn't really...
I didn't actually go and like try to find stuff that would...
Substitute?
Yeah.
Okay, so you know what? You just told me that milk is meant for babies.
Yep.
Yeah? So it is actually baby food? Did you look for milk substitutes?
Yeah, soy milk, yeah.
Yeah, so do you really need milk? Are you a baby? Milk is baby food, right?
Right.
And it's so stuffed in our head that we need milk.
Yep.
But actually, we are not babies. We don't need milk at all. We can get nutrition from, you know, plants, from fruit, vegetables, legumes, pulses, grains, nuts and seeds. And we do not need any kind of milk. But yes, it's difficult to give up certain things, and we want to continue having those things. Then yes, we look.